I should keep there to keep you warm, but you're I'm not playing well. Can I help you hang it by your side? There be something that goes by, I'm getting closer. Another year has come and gone, and all I've been wanting to know, if you just don't know about coming through. Baby, it's Christmas, how can I miss this? The pumpkin party and the rain is through, tonight I'm on a hot
Hey, you log.
And we're back. All right, everyone. Hello, world. Welcome to the New Kids on the Block potluck stream. Happy December 2020 coming to an end. How are you guys doing? It's been a little bit. I haven't seen you guys since the Fenway stream here. That was back in the fall. What's everybody up to? You guys doing okay?
Yeah, doing sure. Great.
Doing great.
Look great.
We look pretty good, considering.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone's so festive. Happy Hanukkah to those, you know, just, you know, gonna, I brought some, so brought some Judaism to the group here for our holiday. Holiday potluck, and it's really good to see you guys. I know you guys were excited to make sure that we wrapped up the year and make sure we got together for the fans and did something festive as we head into the holiday season safely and securely in our homes. Where are you guys right now? I know that some of you have moved around a little bit. John, where are you at? That looks very. You got some Yuletide going on in the background. Where are you? At the farm?
Well, we moved in March, and then we moved again 2 weeks ago. So we're at our newest house, the fireplace. Nice. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Looks lovely. Looks lovely. Yeah. Is anyone else moved around a little bit since we saw you last?
I moved out of the basement. Yeah. I usually do these streams in the basement, but
yeah,
I wanted some Christmas.
Woo!
So I'm in the door. I'm in the. What do they call this? The vestibule.
The foyer.
This is where we do all the. This is where we do all our TikTok.
The foyer. Dances.
Yeah, in the foyer we do all our TikTok dances right there.
The foyer. Yeah, the foyer.
The foyer. Okay,
festive.
Foyer.
And Joe, did you head east?
I'm east. Yeah, I'm in Cape Cod. I'm in the upper Cape.
Cape, huh?
Yeah. And by the way, I just want to let you know right off the bat, this is what I've been trying to open up because, guys, I'm going to be making ornaments and giving them away during our stream, okay? So just if I look like I'm busy with something, that's what I'm busy with. That's and awesome. Just nothing's random, but we're going to pick them from the chat, okay?
Joe, can we get a close-up of the tie, please?
Oh, close-up of the –
Yeah.
Hey.
Donnie in the pre-show said I look like Rodney Dangerfield and
well,
I don't know. That's
only
true.
When you yeah. Only when you went save the jokes.
Save the jokes for the
Joe, should we be worried about the white shirt and the arts and crafts project?
Maybe. But it's 2020, man. It's 2020.
I'd love to hear with a Boston accent. What do they call it in kindergarten when they give you something to cover your clothes? What is that called?
Kindergarten, first of all, it's kindergarten.
Yeah, and Jordan said it.
Kindergarten.
Yeah, that's really old school.
Kindergarten.
Not an apron.
Smock.
Danny, you doing
Smock.
Okay?
Smock.
You're looking
Smock. Great.
Oh, Danny, your tree just went on.
Yeah.
Danny's having a psychedelic Christmas.
Oh. It's a Miami kind of Christmas here. So.
Right.
Neon.
Whoa. Oh, and it affects your whole thing. I love it.
It kind of looks like those kids who put LED lights in their room for TikTok videos. I like it. And Jordan? You brought some color in their background up in the attic.
Yeah. Donnie egged me on, eggnogged me on.
Oh, yeah. I think he said something like, "You're always known for bringing the Santa, Jordan." I mean, step.
Well,
up.
the Santa hat, but I didn't have one, and so I went looking, and I grabbed this from the kitchen, brought it up, and threw it on my chair.
The two things I thought I could bet on was Danny in a very muscly, slightly Christmassy t-shirt. Got that right. And Jordan in a Santa hat. Just fumbled. Fumble-rooski on my end.
Yeah.
But he got a red Santa tree. He got a red tree.
Oh, I got
him.
Look at his little tree. Look at the tree.
You egg-knocked me on.
Shadowing going on here. Because we're going to be taking a bit of a trip down New Kids Christmas history, and there is definitely some footage we're going to get to enjoy. I think Santa Claus is going to make an appearance, spoiler alert, and I think Danny even has a costume change to something even more festive. So there's a lot coming on today's pop-up stream. Well, is everyone just? I know we're all trying to. We can be playing it safe and staying with just our families and everything as we celebrate the holidays. But does anyone have any special plans they're looking forward to coming up for the Christmas season? Oh, look at that,
Joe. Number one, folks.
Nice.
How did you?
We got two puppies coming
with a little bell.
Puppies.
We got two puppies coming. Yeah.
Two nice. What kind of puppies?
They're like mini poodles.
Mini poodles.
Nice.
Mini poodles.
Now you still have a bigger poodle.
He's gone.
How old? Whoa, I was gonna say.
Yeah, he was old. He was old. He was like a very young old doggy. It was heartbreaking. But
how old? But only like 5 or 6, right?
No, he was like 12, 13. Mm. Yeah. He looked really young, but he was old.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Little rascal.
Yeah. Thank you.
That's a bummer.
Yeah.
Sorry, George.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Thank you. But we got two new ones coming. So brighten up our holidays.
Yeah.
Any names? You got the names picked out yet?
Milo and Luna.
Ooh.
Nice.
Milo, Luna. I like them together. Yeah.
Milo, Luna.
It sounds like the next outpost of your Italian restaurant enterprise.
I like that one, Jared.
I wonder how Joe painted that ornament so neat. How did you paint that so neat while you're doing this stream here?
Well, you say that like you don't believe I actually did it.
But I do, but I'm just saying, how did you do it?
I kept it simple. I kept it simple. You know, I used a nice little brush here. Donnie, I have three kids, younger kids, so we got to keep them busy. And so, you know, I got arts and crafts around me a lot. So it's one of those,
I like it.
Yeah. But thank you.
No, it's great. I'm impressed. I'm not skeptical. I'm impressed.
You know, I'm so excited. I meant to do this. And I'm here. It's a NK stream exclusive. Look at that. It's got a little bell on it.
Nice. Remember, one of my nicknames is Shaky D. Because like when I play pool, I shake.
The pool table.
Yeah, and when I paint, it would be the same thing. I could never do a straight line like you did on that ornament. Shaky D.
Shaky D.
Hey, I want to call these out. So faculty, Christian team, you gotta remember who I gave this to. I think I saw a Katie Quaid. Do we know a Katie Quaid on here?
Oh, yeah.
Do we?
Oh, yeah, Katie.
This Katie. One, I hit it, and then she went away. So this is going to Katie Quaid. And on to bigger and better things. Sorry to interrupt. Katie Quaid.
Congratulations, Katie. So the new kids have a long history of celebrating the holidays as a band and with your fans. Obviously, without you guys, Christmas wouldn't be funky. And the Christmas record, thank you. I got dad jokes for days. The The Christmas record came along pretty early, not early in your career, because of course the band had been together for a long time, but it was definitely a major part of your global success. It sold over 2 million records and came out in September 1989. Merry, Merry Christmas by the New Kids on the Block. Can you guys tell me a little bit about where were you
first?
The idea of a Christmas record is.
There it is.
Where were you guys in your lives and your touring when the idea of making a Christmas record came to pass?
we were on tour, probably, and this is one of those times where the record company definitely said, "You got to do a Christmas album." And then we kind of realized it's kind of a rite of passage of all boy bands to do a Christmas album, whether you want to or not. So, but once we started doing it, it was really fun. I think we were touring. I think, I'm not sure which tour we were doing, but we recorded in like Step by Step. I think we recorded some of the songs in hotel rooms.
Yep.
I know we recorded like Funky Christmas in a hotel. And like Maurice would come in town and set up the studio and like leave us alone, and we would just record stuff. And I remember a lot of that being on tour, like right not long before Christmas. So it was like once, you know, what happens, I think, in the business end of it is once you start like getting really successful, the record company starts looking for every way in the world to capitalize and get product out there. For us, you know, we were a little reluctant, but once we started recording, we really liked the songs. We started having fun with it.
Yeah, we did it on 89. We toured with it that tour on at the end of 89.
Uh-huh.
So we recorded it like early in 89, like the summer of 89, maybe, or something like that. That maybe the Tiffany tour where we swapped. So.
But where did we take?
Yep. Yeah.
What he said.
Is that a
he's frozen.
Jordan, we lost you for a second. What'd you say to him?
Breaking up.
Another pun.
I know what we're getting Jordan for Christmas. An Ethernet cable. An Ethernet cable.
Yeah, Jordan, unfortunately we're losing you. Maybe you could sign in and out. You are frozen in like Christmas. There we go. Yeah.
Hey!
Wow. We got some. Yeah, you got some. I think.
Yes.
My back.
Oh man.
Classic.
Yeah, we got you.
Okay.
Wow. So, yeah, I mean, so the New Kids obviously make this Christmas album. It comes out. It is incredibly successful. And it obviously has lived on and stood the test of time. You guys were, like you said, you were on tour, you were releasing the Christmas album as you went along. Do you guys have any memories of, you know, there were obviously some pretty important songs that have become a big part of the catalog and have, you know, still mean a lot to the fans as they celebrate Christmas every year. Do you guys have any memories specifically about the song listing and the original songs that get made on the album? How did those come to pass? Because you guys obviously contributed and wrote some of those songs.
Anyone?
I mean, I specifically, you know, we talked about it before, but the, you know, the Funky Christmas, the recording of that, kind of Donnie producing that and us figuring out our parts and doing that in a hotel room. I could go right back to that. Like the two different hotel rooms, it was like a double room. The board back then, you know, to record, you needed a huge SSL board or some kind of like that. You can't do it on a computer like nowadays. You couldn't. So it was a big operation. And so we did that. I remember how much fun we had doing the songs in the show. It was like we were already having a blast on tour anyway. But the live performing was just so fun and so festive. And so, I mean, we had so much love going on anyways with the fans and us, but like Christmas, it was just like on steroids. And every night, you know, Danny, who dressed up as the mom? Or
Danny was mom.
Danny did the mom. And then every night, probably about three nights into it, Donnie jumped into the Christmas tree. And then that became, he jumped on the, just tackled the Christmas tree every night.
That was my favorite part.
Glitter jackets. And it was
love that.
It was great.
Did we have fake snow back then too?
What's that?
Did we have fake snow back
yeah,
then?
Yeah.
And the blow up things, right. The things will blow up, but the snow is the shit.
The songs to just piggyback Joe. I remember Funky Christmas specifically, the recording of that and the recording of Last Night I Saw Santa Claus. I remember those well, but Funky Christmas, a little side story is, I think, Joe, you were doing your rap. I wrote everyone's raps, and Joe was doing his, and I think he just was getting – I don't know if you were frustrated or whatever, but he just couldn't quite get the flow, and all of a sudden he did it with a British accent. And it was like, let's go with that. And then we just decided for everyone to sort of impersonate someone, and we kind of treated Joe as if he was, like, doing Slick Rick.
Oh, that's right.
And Danny kind of did Rakim, and me and Joe and I did Public Enemy kind of sound, and Jordan was kind of like Fresh Prince. So we just kind of all
or LL, right? People.
Yeah, LL? Yeah, actually, LL, yeah. So we just, it was just kind of one of those things that just happened in the spur of the moment. But in terms of the show, which I don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but the Christmas show, there's so many great memories about that time. In those old days, one thing I think about though is we right now kind of only tour in the summer, and like I'm always thinking about like I wish we could do a Christmas segment like the old days, but we seem to always tour not near Christmas time. So when we did it a few years ago, the little Christmas bit, it was really fun to do, even though it was summer. So now we know that works, but that time of shopping for the jackets that we wore, those sequins jackets, like I remember going shopping with Dick Scott in New York, and he took us like to some of those boutiques in the garment district, right? And where you get like Broadway outfits, and we were all like, at least I remember trying on my jacket, and I got a long one with tails, and it was so fun and just so spur of the moment. And then that Christmas section in the show was one of the most fun things, and it's the only time we did it was that tour, and it was really so fun. I just remember like every night, like we'd have to go change and they would play Merry, Merry Christmas interlude. And some nights it would be like 45 minutes long as we take forever to change. But when we came out, it was just like so much fun. Just
we'd meet like there'd be two and three and we'd walk on and you'd have that thing of a quick change sort of thing. It was that feeling. Yeah. It was cool.
We've got some great stuff to show you guys today and show the fans as we tell these stories. And we our team went digging for as much as we could find from back then. Of course, we don't have the highest quality footage of that, but why don't we take a shot at what we did find, and we can look and see what these guys are talking about if you weren't at these shows.
Selections.
This Christmas, we want to be a special one. We'll be thinking of you. Will you be thinking of us? And all you people out there, you better be good for Santa! Yeah.
journey with us into a world of make-believe and wicked sound. We want to make this Christmas the best ever. So, let's make this Christmas right. Just a trusty
Wow. we got to be a few more like that, but you know, nice to get a little bird's eye view into that segment from the show.
That was crazy.
We didn't have the jackets. Dick must have said, "Boy, y'all need some jackets."
Yeah.
The upgrade.
Yeah.
And that was very reminiscent. The other way, Jordan, when he does his thing on the cruise, when he comes in those characters, that's very.
Oh, the geek. Yeah.
The same. Nerd.
Pre-nerd. That was pre-nerd.
That was pre-nerd, but it, like I didn't know where the lineage came from. That's where it came from.
That funny thing is at the beginning, first of all, the dialogue we said was so Maurice Starr influenced, you could tell. Yeah, I'm going to play a few selections from our thing. And everyone said a lyric from a song on the album. Jordan said, "Keep the Season," or something bright. And Dan, right. John, Joe said, "A Land of Make Believe." You know, And the funny thing is, the first thing we said was, "I know it's a few weeks till Thanksgiving." Like, we must have just finished the album, just put it out, and hadn't even gotten the sparkly outfits, like Joey said.
Mm-hmm. Crazy. Do you think it was like at least after Halloween yet, or do you mean is this?
No, probably the beginning of the tour.
We started in November.
That was the opening of the tour, and that tour I remember ran through New Year's because I think we played like New Year's Eve.
Providence,
Rhode Island, or Worcester Centrum.
We've heard this before, but like, as a dad now, like, can you imagine having to bring your daughter on Thanksgiving evening? You just ate, like, it's that meal, and you got to get into the car and drive to Madison Square Garden and sit there with your daughter. That's wow.
I love it.
That's love.
I love it. I'm
sitting in the dad building.
Yeah, but I was one of those dads that would be bored on the holidays. Like once everything's open, it's like let's go to the movies or let's do. So I would have loved it. Been fun. That's me.
I eat too much.
Yeah, the tryptophan will get you tired. That's true.
Guys, this one's going out to Jerry Lee Levering, if I'm saying that right, because she said one of those ornaments would motivate me to put up a tree. So you're on, Jerry. Go get your tree. Bye.
So obviously, you know, the Christmas record had lots of upbeat, you know, funny and incredible. Now they've been incredibly nostalgic records that that I think have become a big part of everyone's holiday season. Speaking of that, I know you guys saw this, and this was a nice thing. We saw when somebody decorated their entire house and programmed the lights to Funky Christmas. Do you guys remember this? So these records have stood the test of time.
Was that a
course video? Yeah, it was last winter, and it ended up going pretty viral, you know, in the fan base, which is awesome. Here's another actually great fan video. We love these things. I know you guys enjoy seeing them. It's gone. the fans' creativity never dull. This other fan video, they did their own take. This one's pretty good too. I like his metal chain link guitar.
That was awesome.
That was great.
That was
very cool.
That was awesome.
So, the Christmas album also contained a very serious message. Can you guys tell us a little bit about the beginnings and how did This One's for the Children come to be? Because obviously a bit more of a serious take, a beautiful ballad that I know means so much to the fans.
You know, I think we got to give this one to Danny. Danny, it's one of
just say you, Dan.
Take it away, Dan.
I just remember Maurice playing it and then saying, "What does that have to do with Christmas? Like, it's not really a Christmas song." But it went on the Christmas album, and it was the single to the Christmas album, so it never made sense to me. But,
peace and love, man.
Yeah, I get it. You know, yeah. But,
nah.
Is it a Christmas song? Not really.
I thought it was a good Christmas song. I thought it was walking the line, not too Christmas.
Do any of you guys like play the our Christmas album Christmas time?
Yes.
I don't actually. I should put that in the
I do. I have it on a playlist, and This One's for the Children's not on it because it's not a Christmas song.
Mm.
I have a tradition of in Christmas, I guess it was 89, we got a jukebox gift from the record company.
Yeah.
Now, in many ways, that is a story of great irony in the history of the New Kids. But in terms of Christmas, it's a great thing because that Christmas, they got delivered to our houses, and mine got plugged in, and I came home, and my mom had it had it on, and all our Christmas songs are in there. So they all pop up, you know, they pop up. Not every single one of them, but a bunch of them are in there. So when they would play, it was really sweet. It's really sweet. So it's kind of a tradition for me around Christmas time to at least once turn the jukebox on and hope some of those Christmas records come on. It's something sweet when those, like, Letter to Santa comes on in the jukebox. It's kind of cool. It's very cool.
Let's watch a quick clip of the official music video.
This is a very serious message, so all of you, please listen. There are some people have no food to eat, they have no place to go, but we are God's children, we have to learn to love one another, just remember they could be us, remember we are our brothers, I'm not trying to darken up your day.
I think we have
Did Danny pause that before the chorus?
Danny left. You know what's funny?
I think
when we first did the Christmas album photo shoot, we did a whole photo shoot where we dressed down. We had, like, I had on a Red Sox shirt and like a green Letterman jacket, and everybody dressed like sort of not so Christmassy, like that video. And the record company was mortified, and they made us, like, redo it or get on the sleds. I remember we got, like, yelled at, like, get on the sled. And, like, yeah, we didn't want to do that. We didn't want to do that. We wanted to go against that, just downplay it a little bit. Ironically, the same people that made us, for lack of a better phrase, get on that sled, which some of us have come to terms with that sled and really appreciate it now, but they wanted a video that downplayed Christmas in the video. And the way we look in the video is actually how we tried to look on the album cover, just sort of subtle, not make it all Christmas, a little hint of red here, a touch of green there, not so over the top. More like what, you know, 19 and 20 year old young men would want. Now we're all in. Now we don't care. We'll get on the sled anytime.
And you know what's funny about the first photo shoot we did a couple years ago? I went back to the archives to look through all our pictures that Sony has, and those pictures are gone. They're just gone.
There's a few floating around, though. There's a few. I saw one, like, I have a Silver Surfer t-shirt on and stuff. I've seen those around somewhere.
But the main ones, like the spray painted Merry, Merry Christmas, they don't exist.
Yeah,
they're gone.
Yeah, we got grounded.
Hey, Jared, put that other picture up that you showed it before. Does somebody have shorts on in that picture?
Yeah, I think rewind. We were in Hawaii.
Oh,
or something.
No, Dan.
No,
we don't have
shorts. Yeah, I have shorts on.
No, Danny has on shorts. I think Joe does too.
On the sled.
No, right there. That picture there.
Well, on the sled, we're wearing shorts too.
I know where that picture is. I know where it is. That picture's in California. That picture's in Valencia, California.
What? It looks very Valencia, California.
It does. Look at our clothes. No, because I remember there's other teen. It was for a teen magazine, I think.
Yeah. Yep.
Yep. I know because I had that Celtic starter jacket on, and we did a whole photo shoot with some teddy bears and stuff for Big Bopper. Yeah, I remember.
Well, guys, this one's this one's going out to Carrie Lewis. She and my her mom shares my birthday, but she did pass away last year. Well, this is to your mom, Carrie. We love you, and this is to the New Year's Eve babies.
Nice.
Good job, Joe.
Good job, Joe.
So again, this is
going really well.
Busy.
I'm killing this. I didn't know.
I mean, and your white shirt is still looking pristine. I'm proud of you. This is obviously a very, very busy time for the band, and it looks like one of the music videos that they put together was sort of some behind the scenes capturing you guys while you're on the road. Let's check that out.
I didn't even know that existed.
That wasn't a real video, was it?
Was that a real video? Yeah.
That was
They packaged it. They packaged it as a music video. Yeah. I can't take credit for that. I was not around. But yeah, I think it was nice to have
remember
the sentiment. You guys were on the road. You know, you were like you said, the tour went straight through the holidays. So
that's Allstate Arena. At the back door, where I think it was me and Jordan were waving, and all the fans were up at the top of the ramp to come down into the under the building.
Yeah,
still there. Same entry, same everything. Allstate Arena, Rosemont Horizon. It was back then.
You guys still play many a show there? It's where the NKOTBSB tour kicked off in 2011.
Yep.
Great venue. This is another amazing clip as you guys were promoting your Christmas circuit.
There's a dream team of teenage girls everywhere, and there are Inside Story for Christmas weekend, 1989. They're a musical group that's turning into a major industry. In addition to their records, they have deals for merchandise, TV shows, and movies, and the unwavering adoration of hundreds of thousands of teen and preteen fans.
I think we have sort of a hunger for the scream of the crowd.
We get up there, we're excited, the fans start going crazy.
We're just really, you know, five guys from Boston.
They are just about the hottest thing in show business. Billboard magazine has just named them the top new pop artist of 1989. Their multi-platinum album, Hangin' Tough, has grossed more than $50 million. Their six-month tour, Screaming Room Only, is virtually sold out.
Screaming Room Only?
What?
There's a lot going on in that video, but I'd like to respect the tassel on her dress. Maybe if we could get that, Joe could turn it into an ornament. I think it would go places for sure. It's awesome.
I got partners.
ET's always been good to us.
Yes.
ET's always been good to us. There still aren't.
Good.
No, obviously, this was such an amazing time for you guys. There was so much going on. And I know that one of the things that is an important part of the history of the band was you guys made a trip.
Hey, wait, Jordan has a new background. Jordan has a new ornament.
Hey.
Talking. Yeah.
Dad.
The dad.
Yes. Yes, very.
Yeah, I had to come downstairs because I think Eric's sucking up all the Wi-Fi downstairs. Playing, I took a picture of him yesterday. I said, "Oh my God, you look like a hack."
He looks like a what?
Hold on.
He looks like a what?
A straight hacker. A hacker.
Oh my God.
Oh man.
He looks like every one of your fans trying to get tickets to your next door when they go on sale. So you guys were on tour, you were heading out west, and you got an invitation to perform for I think the second time in your career on Arsenio Hall, right?
Second time.
That part of your That's right. So does anyone remember what you performed or how that performance came to be? what it was like? I mean, at this time, obviously Arsenio was a huge supporter, gave you guys spoke when you got your walk on the Hall of Fame. But this is, you know, it's, his show was the absolute.
Yeah. Star on the Walk of Fame. Yes.
What did I say?
Walk on the Hall of Fame. I don't know what you said.
Hall of Fame.
We know what you meant.
Everybody knew what I meant.
I know we were on tour again doing that interview. I think that you just watched on ET was around that same time. And we got asked to do Arsenio again right before Christmas. There's a lot to that day. There's a lot. I just know our first time on Arsenio, I think people thought it was great, but I think we did not. And I think part of going back, we were kind of like really determined to have a great time and to be loose and free. I think the first time we did it when we were younger, we were a little uptight and didn't give our best performance. And in some ways, it was kind of like going back to, we were on tour. We were playing the Universal Amphitheater that night. I remember that. And I remember we decided to do fun for Christmas so we could have the best time. Yeah.
What is happening?
Eric's hacking us. Eric's definitely hacking us. And I think John didn't perform, but there was no real story to it. I think it was we wanted to do, I think for all some of us, it was like, let's go redeem ourselves on Arsenio and have a great time. And I think for John, it was like, yeah, but you're doing Funky Christmas. I don't rap. I don't do nothing. I'm just going to be standing there the whole time. So why don't you go without me?
I'm breaking up here. I just wish back then I knew how much of a real, genuine rock star John was. Mm. I mean, all the great bands always have a member who just doesn't show up from time to time. I didn't know any better. I mean, you guys know that. You could make a long list of what I didn't know and what I continue not to know. But the guy didn't show up. Hey, you know, it created this mystique. It was very genuine, but it was just, I mean,
created an opportunity too, though, because Arsenio had put out a song or album as Chunky A, an alter ego.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was like one of my first delves into like doing mashups. Like we do so many, like the mixtape tour, we do so many mashup things now. So I actually wanted to get Arsenio to rap as Chunky A on the Christmas song. So he did rap. He didn't do Chunky A, but he actually did do a verse, which was a lot of fun. Yeah, and at the end of it, we were singing like Chunky Chunky Christmas instead of Funky Funky Christmas because it was supposed to be Chunky A. So I think when we told his producers, hey, they're going to rap and they want you to rap, I think he was like, great. But the concept was he would like go change and come back as Chunky A. But
yeah,
obviously he just did it as Arsenio. But it was still amazing.
I just remember how out of breath I was, so pumped up. It was crazy. Like I could barely breathe. And do you remember? I think, Donnie, you remember, like I switched a line like on the fly.
Yeah. Yeah. I think you got
it. I don't know how I did it, but I the grace of God was with me because I would have been so bummed if I messed up and like I switched the line, but I was just like ready to explode. Then I jumped on your part at the end. I was like a chicken with my head cut off. It was crazy.
I think it went good though.
It was a blast. No, yeah. It went good. It went good, but I was.
I remember we watched it. We all watched it in the dressing room after the show. It was like it was cool.
I think we have some footage. Let's take a peek and relive this amazing moment.
Okay, quiet down. We know what millions of girls all over the world want Santa to bring them for Christmas. My next guest, performing the hit single, Funky Funky Christmas, from their platinum album, Merry Merry Christmas. Please welcome the New Kids on the Block. Are you ready?
Ready as the lemon bee.
Daddy, you know, Joey, show us, Joey,
should have stopped.
No!
I'm looking at this melody, cause you're the K-Bill. Oh, so clean. Throw your hands in the air. Kick the ballistic Santa Claus. Sneaky downstairs on Christmas Eve, I saw a sight you wouldn't believe. See Nick by the fireplace. Dustin, I was moody when the runner's face. He said, Harrison, what he said, you were twit. I left the fire burning and he burnt his work. So now I've learned, you gotta turn. The boy's gonna stop saying the work and burn. No bill in the body of the year. It's gonna be showing fresh rounds of hope. Going outside, but we hold up home. Santa's on the way, slavery, springing, swinging. Everybody's asking.
Have a funky, funky Christmas.
The new kids on the block, minus one.
That was the first time you said it. Minus one.
Yeah.
There it was.
That's a thing. That lives on to this day.
Oh, minus one.
Famous quote.
The new kids on the block, minus one.
You guys were dancing your asses off. I was like, what?
That was insane.
Yo, that group choreo was nuts.
Straight energy, y'all.
I think what we're seeing in that clip, you know, as someone that's, you know, gotten to watch the way you prepare and how you seize these moments, I mean, you're seeing a band at the absolute pinnacle of their you know, creativity, and you guys are so in sync with each other, and like John, you're there right there with them, and they're making you proud, but it's just. That's some Motown 25 stuff right there. I mean, I've been putting this stream together with the faculty team and just had the opportunity. I'm familiar with that performance, but I hadn't watched it recently, and I hadn't watched as many times as I watched it recently. I'm obsessed with that moment. And it just shows you've been on the road. You've been around the world. You guys were on stage every night together, and you just killed it. I mean, that performance is so amazing. It's amazing.
It was special. I'm not saying the performance itself was spectacular, although there was some moments. Joey's ass, Jordan's abdominals,
skinny ass. Jordan knows.
I always remember Joe's butt shake and Jordan jumping on the railing at the very end and teasing the fans as like, wow, moments of like, these dudes were just in the moment, in the present moment. And that was like a, I think that was the one of the motivations of choosing that song, because we just wanted to go have fun and not be so uptight and serious as we were the first time. And I think on the tour, John, you maybe didn't even do Funky Christmas, and that was part of it. It was like, we got to teach John the choreography in 5 minutes to get to Arsenio. And he was like, I ain't learning this shit. Just go do it without me. Mm. But I noticed Maurice Starr was playing guitar in the background, you know, and that was really sweet. And Arsenio, you know, there are people on the journey, like I said, like Entertainment Tonight was always good to us. They really were, like from John Tesh and Lisa Gibbons and Mary Hart days to now Nichelle Turner. Like that, for whatever reason, that show's always been sort of like right there along our journey. And Arsenio was like such a integral part of our journey from the outside. You know, he gave us one of our first big opportunities on his show, and we like loved his show, and to perform there was like, it was like the pinnacle, right? And then, you know, it was the okay performance. It was sort of not our finest hour, and it was early on. To us, it was a make or break. And I think in some ways we were like, oh, we might've just ruined our chance, but we obviously overcame that. But he let us come back. When the whole lip sync controversy came, we turned to him to go through, you know, to help us, you know, come out and speak up and sing and perform for ourselves and you know, sort of put an end to that whole thing. And, you know, when his show was ending, you know, we were one of the final guests. I mean, just so many times along the way he was there. And of course he gave us our star in the Walk of Fame. He's someone, I'll just always be so grateful to him. You know, he helped launch my brother Mark, you know, when I was debuting Mark's album. Like that was like the first major TV performance Mark got to do. And he just was so great to us, and one of those people along the way that won't really get credit for being part of our success, but is really a big part of it. And the confidence we got just going on his show and doing well and having him be so supportive of us, that confidence
goes so far.
He just, shout out to Arsenio. I just love him and so grateful to him always.
Yep. Agree. So,
not everyone realizes that late night shows obviously pre-tape and then air that evening. So the way that day worked is you guys were in on your tour. You were doing many sold out nights at what is no longer in LA, but it is the Universal Amphitheater. So you would have run over and sound checked and performed at Arsenio, but then that evening you had a sold out show at the Universal Amphitheater. And you guys, I don't know if any of you remember this, but probably you do. You came off stage just in time to watch Arsenio. Do you guys remember watching Arsenio in your dressing room?
I remember it. I remember a lot about that day. I remember a lot about that day. Some other stories we can tell after, but I do remember us all sitting around watching it. I don't remember the vibe, but I remember we had a crowded dressing room and we watched.
Well, a couple of years ago, faculty, New Kids Management were contacted that there were a number of boxes full of videotapes that needed to be protected because they had actually been in a garage that had some leaking in it back in the East Coast. So we were able to get our hands on these videotapes and store them carefully. And we haven't gone through all of them yet, but we've gone through a few of them and we found a clip. I don't know if you guys have ever seen this.
Plumbing. Think about it. We take that trip for no reason. It's all the same plumbing. I think We don't like to drink water near where we
going outside on the car.
Hey, that's Mrs. C. That's Mrs. C.
Wow.
Yes.
That was Mrs. C.
With the girls from Full House.
Dang.
Yeah. That
was backstage.
A lot of people. M. Lou was there. All the family. T-Mac, Dave.
Bob Wolf. Yeah, one of the things I remember.
Jimmy Marsh.
Sitting on his lap practicing.
I know. It was awesome. Awesome.
Oh, my God.
Bob Wolf. So that day, does everyone remember we had that meeting with Bob Wolf that day?
Yeah.
We got the news, yeah.
And, I mean, I don't want to get into the details, but basically we were, like, getting, like, $350 a week in our bank accounts, in our ATMs. And Bob called a meeting. And every now and again, he'd say, all right, you're going to get this. And, you know, he had a meeting, and it was like he just – I don't want to get into it, but just because I'll cry.
He told us we had a certain amount of money.
Yeah, we were like.
And we were teenagers.
Yeah, they would always meet with us and say, all right, you're going to get $10,000 each this week. And it was like 1988. And we were like, awesome. Yeah, this is incredible. I'm going to buy a scooter. I'm going to buy a moped. And before that show, he said, all right, we're going to give you guys your quarterly disbursement of money. And we were like, all right, awesome. And he was like, it's $1 million each. And everybody was crying.
He wrote it on the whiteboard. I remember him writing it on the whiteboard.
Oh, really?
Really?
Danny, yeah. Famous for his, he always has the best reactions. When we got good news, Danny, I remember when Emlu gave you the first 45, you were sitting in the front seat and you somehow did a flip over the front seat and landed back in the back seat. That's the kind of stuff. And I just remember us being excited, but Danny like flying out of the room, like just running out of the room, you know, down the hall, coming back in. Yeah, that was a wild weekend, man. And all the people there. And that's the room, that same dressing room where it was before I was getting ready for one of the shows. And I was 16, so I could eat a sleeve of Oreos and a can of Pepsi as a warm-up. And that's what I would do. And so I had a stack of Oreos, and I was in a towel ready to get ready. And I turned to the dressing room door, and it opened up. And standing there was Elton John.
Wow. That was, yeah, dream come true for him.
It was, yeah, I know. Everybody says that, yeah.
Oh, wow. But
it was a dream come true for me.
A fantasy come true.
That's awesome. Yeah, that was a huge day. I remember it was just, you know, like I said, that Arsenio performance, even though John wasn't there, I know nobody was like, there was no hard feelings or anything. Everybody understood what was going on. But to do that and go like back to the show, like to have a success there, to have that meeting, to like know that like we're finally making it. And then I remember we flew home the next day And everybody, after we were told, like, all right, you're getting some money, we were all like, oh boy, we can get cars. Can we get cars? Mm. And our accounts were like, yeah, but don't go crazy. We were like, no. And I think Joey got his dad a car. I got my brother Mark a car. And everybody got a car. And when we flew home the next morning, we all got driven, and the five cars were sitting there. And it was like a Jeep, you know, nothing crazy, no like Ferraris, just like a Jeep Cherokee. And, you know, like that was my brother Mark's dream car. So I bought it and gave it to him. And Joey, I think, gave his dad a Cadillac. And everybody's had a little car sitting there. And it was just a great moment. And when you're a kid growing up with no car, I don't think anyone in this band's family had a car. You know, growing up, I don't remember anyone having a car.
I bought a lot of cars for people.
Yeah, later. But just to be able to buy a car was like, you know,
it was the greatest.
We made it. We could buy a car.
Yeah, I mean, buying your dad a Cadillac, and I know we all got to do so many fun things. It was dope. That was a magical time for sure. Christmas. Yeah. And then, no,
I'm kidding. No, Christmas seems to be a central character in this wild ride you guys are on, the record you made, the tours you guys were on.
Speaking of Christmas, the
ornament.
This one's going out to Kelly Hopkinson and her son. She's in the UK. Her son's 9 years old. I don't have his name, but we're gonna just give it to the family. All right. This one's going out to you, my man. He's 9 years old.
Yeah. So Christmas is definitely is. We're going to make sure that everyone who wants these ornaments will take good care of them and get them to the right people. Has been a big part, obviously, the comic book, the Christmas cartoon, and then also just an important time you guys have always spent with, you know, with your families. You know, we got some nice Christmas moments here.
There he is. There it is.
There's Rose.
Ah. Oh.
Donnie and his friend.
Yeah, like me that. And Rudolph, we go back.
You guys and your friend, the elf on the shelf. And we also have a couple other things that the guys have put together as they plan for the holiday seasons. I wanted to share with you guys. Joe, you sent us a clip that I want to share with everyone. Here we go.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents under the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. Oh, I'll be home for Christmas if only my dream.
Beautiful.
No, I discovered iMovie in 2020. That's what I got out of 2020, iMovie. Y'all know the same moves and the fun. Yeah. You know, it's that.
That all works.
I got a most works.
It's beautiful.
Nice. Really nice.
Where can I find that song, Joe?
What's that?
Where is that song?
That is from Come Home for Christmas, available on all streaming platforms.
Hold on, I gotta download it right now. That was awesome.
That made me mushy.
Your Christmas album is on my playlist.
Thank you. I don't take that lightly, Danny. I don't take that lightly.
Love it. You got some good ones on there.
Yeah. Hey. Some of my best work.
Finally, some respect.
That really made me very. That was very emotional. Good job, Joe.
Thanks, man. Yeah.
And honestly, speaking of picking up new habits and skills like iMovie, Joe, who's also put out some amazing soul music with Own This Town, and I'm sure everyone will go and listen to that Christmas record. Danny has been also hard at work. Everybody knows he is quite the chef, and you've been recently posting these amazing cooking videos and started the YouTube channel, right?
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. What?
You have a YouTube channel?
Yeah, to share my recipes and especially to share some of my mom's recipes with all the blockheads out there. So
amazing.
What's it called, Danny? I want to subscribe right now.
It's called The Woodworks.
Woodworks?
Coming on that. I'm future guest 21.
Yeah, I was like your opening act. So I've warmed it up for you, Donnie. You got this. But it was really fun being on. We actually, those who haven't seen it, I had a chance to hang out with Danny, and he asked me some really fun questions about my history and how we all got to know each other. So check that video out. I think the blockheads will enjoy some of those stories. But Danny, you also put together a great video. And let's hit that.
Happy fun. Holidays! I am going to make my mother's coffee cake. Her recipe. She wrote in her own handwriting for me, laminated. I always have it. I always break it out when I'm making this. Even though I kind of know the recipe, I like to look at it and be reassured that I'm doing the right thing. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to sift the dry ingredients. And this calls for 3 cups of flour, 1 teaspoon of salt, and 1.5 teaspoons of baking soda, 1.5 teaspoons of baking powder. The next thing I'm going to do is cream the butter and the sugar. I have 1.5 sticks of butter, and it calls for 1.5 cups of sugar. Next thing I'm going to do is add the 3 eggs. And I'm going to mix that up a little bit. A 1 teaspoon of vanilla. All right. The things that are left to add is the sour cream and the dry ingredients. Now is where I double check everything, make sure I got everything in there, because the last thing is the sour cream for the batter. So I'm checking the list. I got my sugar, I got my butter, eggs, flour, this is the sour cream, baking powder, baking soda, vanilla, salt. That's it. Now here comes the sour cream, 1.5 cups. Done. Okay, so I have my pan. This is my official coffee cake pan, buttered. Have my batter, and now I have 1/4 cup, a little more than 1/4 cup of brown sugar and regular sugar. Just mix that up, because this is gonna be what makes the ring in the middle of the cake. I'm gonna add usually probably 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, and then I also like to add a little nutmeg. It's kind of my own thing. I love nutmeg. I use it on my oatmeal. You just need like their little nuts, and then you just have to have a little grater, or any grater. So the way this is gonna go is you're gonna put a third down, then a layer of cinnamon. I mean, layer the cinnamon mixture with the sugars. Then the other third, and then more cinnamon, and put the rest, and then on top, you're gonna add more of the sugar mixture. So I got all my layers done. It's ready to go in the oven. You want your oven at 325, and it's between 50 and 60 minutes. This has to bake. Betty Wood's coffee cake. It's my family's absolute favorite thing on the holidays for sure. Hope you enjoy it. The coffee cake is ready. The house smells wonderful. It smells like the holidays. So let's take it out the oven. Have a look. Just look at that. I mean, that's perfection. It's perfect. Thanks, Mom. I'm very lucky to pass this recipe on to my kids. It's awesome. Enjoy it.
Oh, that's awesome.
That is so cool.
Yes.
Thank God.
The Muscle T made it. The Muscle T.
That tank is awesome.
Yes. It's great memories, man. Go ahead, Jordan. Sorry.
Jared. No, I was just going to say, Jared, you did a turkey. What is it? Turkey sausage?
Yeah, we did a recipe with like turkey sausage and peppers that my kids like a lot. And Danny was doing this thing where he wants to learn all those recipes. So I sent him the recipe and then he cooked it during the show. And it was fun. A lot of fun.
Yeah. The cool thing is to see after the episode airs, all the fans doing it like that week. So they send me pictures of how they made it. And we got some. Right. In the Blockheads, we got some really good chefs out there, man. Some of them are really amazing. So
yeah,
it's fun.
That's cool.
And where do you get how do you get the recipes, Danny? Do you post them?
The Woodworks official.com. They just download them there.
Awesome.
We'll go ahead and post that specific recipe, that amazing cake.
You gotta post that Reese cup, your mom's homemade Reese cup recipe, Danny.
Oh yeah.
We might have to do that when I come on your show.
Oh. Yeah, I will be reaching out to everyone.
Yeah.
One of the easiest things for the fans to do if you haven't done it yet is just go ahead to YouTube and subscribe, and that way every time Danny posts a video you'll get it, just like also how the new kids do that. And also we try to feature all the individual guys' activities over YouTube as well. I mean, listen, I know that as we talk about this holiday season, so many of us out there in the world, you know, we're missing our daily lives. We're missing our family and friends that we can't be with. And we surely are all missing each other. I know how badly the new kids miss each other and how much they talk all the time about when we can get back out, talk about getting back all around the world, when's it's going to be safe, and when can we start gathering people together, because that's what the new kids do. As you see, as we take this trip down memory lane through the holidays, through the history of the band, it is all about being together, whether it was the Toys for Tots event that these guys did back in 2009 to raise money for charity, and which was so beautiful, the House of Blues, or their Christmas tours, or even bringing their Christmas music to you in the summertime when they played it on the cruise or on their tours. Christmas is, I think, it just represents us all being together. And I think that's the sentiment that we all want to convey to you, everyone who's out there watching, is that I know how badly these guys want to be back out with you. So we are constantly talking to our promoters. We're looking at what all the local rules and regulations are. We will always make sure that your safety is what we first, but as soon as it's possible, we will be back out on the road making plans to come to your city as soon as we can make it happen. And I know that's what the new kids want. We're working hard on when it's safe to reschedule a cruise. And I think that, you know, that's one of the things that kind of represents the togetherness, even though unfortunately the cruise can't fit all of you. It has become a bit of a heartbeat for the band. And one of the things that that Donnie has talked a lot about is some of the things we've learned on the cruise have kind of spread into our daily lives and plans. So I know for some reason I think we talk a lot about it a lot, and I think it's the right reasons, because it represents the ultimate togetherness. But Donnie, you've been working on something I think that represents what yeah. cruise,
well,
right?
just to say, you know, just like Dan, Joey's video made me really emotional, so I'm still kind of like, I a lot of this stuff, you know, we do this and we love being with our fans and sharing this time. And we've talked a lot about a lot of stuff this time, but just watching some of those old videos, you know, there's a lot of family in it. There's a lot of really special memories, but you know, we're also in, you know, we're still in this COVID world, and I hate to even bring that up right now, 'cause I know we're just spending this holiday moment together, but we started this whole quarantine together with the virtual cruise, and I was just working on putting something together. I fell in love with this record during this whole pandemic, and it's like my go-to record, like to just think about, you know, how the best is still yet to come for us and all you blockheads out there. And I just love this record, and it's nothing to do with Christmas. I just love this song so much, and I wanted to put something together for you guys outside of this stream, just a message of hope for all of us to get together again soon. And I wanted to sort of tell the story. We've done videos of the boat before, but I wanted to do it more from what might be your perspective, being the fans and the blockheads. And I was gonna just put this on the internet, and Jared and I talked about the stream, and I said, you know, I'll save it for the stream and just be a message of hope for everyone for next year. And I know we're gonna be together again. And the song is called On the Ocean. It's not about sailing. It's about, it's a really emotional song for me, sorry. I just love this record. It's every time I hear it, I think about you guys and that we'll be together again soon. So I just put something, a little video together for you guys, just for what my vision of 2021 looks like for us. So I'll just leave it at that, and you can play it, Jared. I love you guys.
Man. Moment I've been waiting on. And my soul's overflowing with anxieties and expectations. Full of desires. Oh, I just want it so bad. Oh, you know? Oh, baby. And it just seems so real. It's right there. Just wanna reach out and touch it before it all disappears. Sometimes it feels like everything is passing me by. Every now and then it feels like my ship has gone and sailed away. But I gotta be strong. Gotta hold on. It won't be too long.
Now the tide is coming in. I see the waves flowing out there on the ocean. I know my ship is coming in. Past the horizon, and right where the sky ends, it's out there on the ocean. Know my ship is coming in, so don't leave me hanging. I've been waiting too long for this moment. My ship has finally come. I will travel to the seven seas. I will even go wherever the wind blows me. I'll do anything to find my destiny. It's like fighting with gravity, and it's bringing me down. If this world is really round, then tell me how. It's just enough for you to come around. It's coming in, coming in. Just the horizon, and right where the sky ends. It's out there on the ocean. Know my ship is coming in, so don't leave me hanging. I've been waiting too long
this moment, my ship has finally come. Yeah.
That was so beautiful.
Put you in a mood, man.
Beautiful.
Ah.
Well, I love you, guys.
That's the antidote to 2020 right there. That's the vaccine right there. Come on.
Oh. Man, I miss you guys so much now. Damn, that was so cool. Wow.
Ah. Love you guys.
Well, right. I think that that is a beautiful way to send off this year, to wrap up this potluck holiday stream, and just with the message that until we meet again, we sail again, we get to have concerts again, and everyone gets to, of course, live the lives that they've come accustomed to, and we'll do it together. So I'm sure we'll be seeing everyone online next year, and you know, I think that's a great way to send off the year. What do you guys think?
Yeah,
give another winner.
One more. Little cherry on the top right there. This one's going out to Emily Schreiber. Sounds like a Jewish name, so I mean, we got a little Hanukkah maybe, I don't know. If not, she says, my NKOTV tree is full of buttons and pictures of the boys and confetti from the concerts. Would love an ornament. Well, there you have it, Emily, coming to you. And thank you, Donnie, for that beautiful video. It really is important that we don't forget.
Yeah. Yeah.
What we have.
Yep. Love you guys.
All right. So
love you guys.
See you guys online, and we'll surely see everybody next year. Thanks to you guys. Thanks to the new kids for helping throw this potluck. It was really, really fun to be with you guys.
Thank you, Jared.
Celebrate.
Thank you and your gang, Jared. Thank you.
Hold on. Hold on.
My computer's dying.
Okay, I'll see you later. But I've been rocking this on social media, so this is my mask. And every day I light a candle. But what I did realize though is that I went the wrong way, because in Jewish you guys read the other way. So I'm lighting it the wrong way, but you know, you'll forgive me.
We appreciate you celebrating the Festival of Lights, and your nose is the shamash, as we say. It's the main candle. It was right down the middle. It's beautiful. All right. Well.
Oh no.
happy holidays, everybody.
Stay safe. We gotta wait.
Yeah, Donnie said his computer was dying.
Is he getting?
They may have lost him.
Help!
Don't forget about this. The New Kids on the Block Holiday Collection. Donnie was rocking it today.
I want
like it. Oh, man. Send me a box, Jared.
Yo. FedEx.
Send me a box. Everybody gets a box.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
We get a box?
Bye, you guys. Stay safe, okay?
Bye, guys.
See ya.
Is Donnie getting
thank
back?
You guys.
I love you. Any time, any way, Merry Christmas.
Ain't no that Santa's on his way.
Well, Pat. Well, Pat.
And every moment's child is gonna smile.